Here's the ensemble learning algorithm. We're done, Michael. We're done with the entire lesson. We don't have to do anything else anymore. We know that we're supposed to look over a subset of data, pick up rules, and then combine them. So what else do you need to know in order to write your first ensemble learning algorithm?
So I'm already kind of uncomfortable with this notion of combine, right? So like I can think of lots of really dumb ways to combine things, like choose one at random or, you know, I don't know, add them all up and divide by pi. I mean, so presumably there's got to be some intelligence in how this combination is taking place.
Yes, you would think so. But you're not at all bothered about how you pick a subset?
Oh, I was imagining you meant random subsets.
Oh, so you'd already made an assumption about how we were going to pick a subset. You just weren't sure
how
to combine them. Well, actually, let's explore that for a minute. Here's kind of the dumbest thing you could imagine doing that turns out to work out pretty well. We're going to pick subsets by, I'm going to say uniformly, just to be specific about it. So we're going to do the dumbest thing that we could think of, or one of the dumbest things you could think of, or maybe we should say simplest and not dumbest, so as not to make a value judgment. That you could think of doing, which would be to just uniformly, randomly choose among some of the data and say, that's the data that I'm going to look at, and then I'm going to apply some learning algorithm to it. Is that what you were thinking of, Michael?
Yeah.
Okay, so just pick a subset of the data, apply a learner to it. I'll get some hypothesis out. I'll get some rule out, and now I'm going to combine them. So since we're being simple, why don't we try doing something simple for combining? Let's imagine, Michael, that we're doing regression. What's kind of the simplest thing you could do if you have 10 different rules which tell you how you should be predicting some new data point? What's the simplest thing you can imagine doing with them?
So each of them spits out a number. I guess if we kind of equally believe in each of them, a reasonable thing to do would be to average.
Right. So a very simple way of combining, in the case of regression, would be to average them. We'll simply take the mean. And by the way, why wouldn't we equally believe in each of them? Each one of them learned over a random subset of the data. You have no reason to think anyone's better than the other.
There's a couple reasons. One is it could be a bad random subset. I don't know how I would measure that.
It could be a good random subset.
Yeah, and then we'd want that to count more in the mean. But I guess I was thinking more in terms of maybe for some of the subsets, you know, it gets more error than others, or it uses a more complex rule than others or something.
I can imagine that. Actually, maybe we can explore how this sort of idea might go wrong. Let's do that. Maybe we can do that with a quiz. You like quizzes, right?
They're important.